theswirlworld.com. Podcast episode
134.
The Swirl World.
Interracial.
Diverse.
Beautiful.
Today's shout out goes to my partner in crime, Adrian London Leach. Adrian curates the content over on the Swirl World Facebook page, and she does one in a million things, like producing this podcast show. I want her to know how very much I appreciate her. She's been with the Swirl World almost from day one and has been invaluable in creating community, building relationships, and just all around helping me to stay sane. Again, today's shout out goes to my partner in crime, someone that I love and care for very much, Adrian London Leach. Also want to say thanks to her husband because he's the wind beneath her wings and he kind of keeps all of us sane over at the Swirl World. Thank you, Adrian. I really, really appreciate you.
And now let's check in to today's show.
To swirl well, you have to date well, period. You have to know what your boundaries are, how to vet better, how to stand your ground, most of all, to know that you are worth it.
Hello, beautiful people. This is Michelle Matthews Calloway, also known as a Swirl Girl, coming at you on behalf of theswirlworld.com, where we celebrate Black women, mind, body, soul, and spirit. Adrian and I have a very special show for you today. We have a big announcement. That's right. We want to tell you about something new that we're offering in the Swirl World. We strive to provide quality content that's both inspirational and motivational for Black women. We recognize the fact that many of the women in the Swirl World want to meet and marry men of quality. And we also recognize that there are a lot of men of quality out there who want to meet and marry Black women. Never fear, we have something special just for you. We're going to share with you something that we think you're going to really like, something that we know is going to enhance your ability to swirl with confidence. Keep listening.
Hello, Michelle. How are you doing today?
I am doing well, Adrian. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. You know, we want to talk about our new group. And one of the things that we want to discuss is what we are all about. What makes us a little bit different than all of the others that are out there? What is it about us, Swirl with Confidence, that's going to set us apart for many of these young ladies that want to date smarter, better, and well?
What sets us apart is the fact that we take a holistic approach to Black women, and we don't just focus on the dating component. We approach Black women mind, body, soul, and spirit. And we believe if you get your mind right, enter anything, not just dating, but anything you want to endeavor to do and be successful at with the proper mindset and the proper tools, then you're going to achieve success. And that, I believe, is what really makes us distinct and sets us apart. And also the way we approach how we equip Black women and provide those tools and tips.
Absolutely, Michelle, because, you know, it is, yes, we want them to find the person that's perfect for them, right for them. But it's not always that. And everybody isn't in the same stage of life. If we're looking at this holistically, sometimes you want to be prepared or you want to get yourself prepared so that you can date well. Sometimes you are coming out of situations where you just need to get your mental headspace straight. And just sometimes you want to be around another group of women that we all share the same common bond, so that you feel that you have someplace safe to talk about things, maybe even to talk about grittier things that you wouldn't normally do on an open platform, such as the Swirl World. And I love the Swirl World, as you know, and we're a pretty safe environment over there, but it's still an open platform, and our platform being private is a little bit different. But, you know, Michelle, talk about that a little bit. You yourself are in a different phase of life, stage of life when it comes to companionship, you know, dating and so forth. So tell us a little bit about that. Tell us how Swirl with Confidence can assist with that.
The great thing about Swirl with Confidence is the fact that whatever stage of life a woman finds herself in, for example, I'm a widow, been a widow for quite a bit and have done different things during this time frame that I've been a widow. There have been different things that I focus on. I've dated during that time, but there have been phases where that wasn't, in a sense, my primary focus. And so we may have women who are coming in who may be widowed for a while or recently widowed and thinking they're ready to get back into the swing of things. Same for women who are maybe newly divorced or have been divorced for a while and thinking, okay, I've done this, I've done that, I've achieved this goal and that goal, and now I'm ready to, in a sense, focus on my relationship life. Whatever stage that woman finds herself in, she can find what she needs in the Swirl with Confidence group. And that's the, I think, the beauty of it. The tools and tips and challenges and masterclasses and Facebook Lives and private Facebook Lives, let me add, that we provide are all designed to help women no matter what stage of life they're in, because the information is something she can apply wherever she is.
Absolutely. And in that, as we were speaking about holistically, we absolutely agree that to swirl well, you have to date well, period. You have to know what your boundaries are, how to vet better, how to stand your ground. Most of all, to know that you are worth it, to know that you are worthy of dating a man that is someone that you would consider appropriate for you, be it financially, emotionally, educationally. That's your choice. That's your total decision. However, we try to encourage women to stop putting the decision in the hands of the man to determine whether you are worthy of the date and to pull that power back. You know, one of the things that we discuss, Michelle, is femininity. And mm-hmm. one of the things that I grew up, because I'm a little bit older, and one of the things I grew up with is that a woman's femininity absolutely was her, not only her crown jewel or her, what made her beautiful, it was also her power, because she knew that she was the prize. He was going to do what he had to do in order to win her, to woo her, to get her to notice him. You know, he was going to make sure that those things were in place. And a lot of that's been lost today. Wouldn't you agree?
Oh, for sure. In so many instances, the tables have been turned.
Yes.
And unfortunately, women are the ones who feel like that. And when I say they have to measure up, what I mean is they, in a sense, mold themselves. I say twist themselves sometimes into pretzels, into being what they think that man wants, instead of realizing that I am a person of worth and value, and I am someone to be desired and to be pursued and to be viewed as a prize and to be viewed as someone to be loved and cherished. And there are men who are still looking for that today.
And, oh, absolutely.
Yeah. And it's a matter of bringing the two together. Again, that mindset has to be correct. You have to view dating with a proper mindset.
And we learn about that in Swirl with Confidence group. And the other thing we learn is about our boundaries and vetting and so forth. And I've said this 1,000 times, Michelle. You've often chuckled at me. I am not mad at men in any way, shape, or form because of what they want. Whether we agree with their standards or not, or whether we agree with their boundaries or not, or what they determine is what they're looking for in a person, whether we think it's beautiful or whether we think it's superficial, they have them. They have standards and they stick to them. No woman that I have recently read about or talked to has come in and said, well, he had this standard and I was able to get him to change it. It always ends up with him having this standard and the woman questioning whether her standards were too high and should she adjust them so that they can more align with what his is. And that's one of the things we try and explain. I mean, I give them props. They have standards. They maintain them. They keep them. They don't change them for any reason.
And that's so true. And it's just a matter of going back to the mindset and recognizing that just as that is their right, it is our right as women to have our own set of standards and boundaries and negotiables and non-negotiables and deal breakers, and not come down on those to try to meet someone who's at a lower level of the standard that we've set, but to meet men who are complementary and compatible with the standard that we have set. You know, there are men out there that may say, to just use for an example, that, you know, I don't pay for dates or I go Dutch. Well, that's not my standard. So I don't have to worry about you because you don't meet my standard as far as who pays for dates. And it makes it easy. He can keep to his. I can keep to mine. I just know that he's not compatible.
And I agree with that. And I think that's so important to try and teach and get ladies to understand that they're not bad guys because that's their standard. That's their standard. If they don't meet yours, then you just move on. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't come, it doesn't begin to, it's not a blame thing. It's not one of these things where you change what your standard is and then you get angry that it doesn't work. You know, I call that the accountability game. You yourself are responsible for your own actions. I'm not saying that people can't say or do things that get you in an emotional way or make you think a certain way or have you feeling a certain way. All of those things may be true. However, the bottom line is, how do you act upon it? And that is totally on you in regards to your accountability. And we talk about that. We talk about being accountable for your behavior, accountable for how you go at things, accountable for how you make your determination. And we tell you, if it doesn't work out, let's not play the blame game. Let's learn from our errors. Let's learn from our poor choices. And let's just move on. There's 7 billion, is it? 7 billion people out there.
Over 7 billion.
Mm-hmm. You know, let's just move on to the next one.
That's so true. And one of the things that we really stress in the Swirl with Confidence group is to not tap into a scarcity mindset and mentality that, oh, I have to adhere to what this guy is saying because if I don't date him, then I'm not going to meet anybody else. Absolutely not. Again, there are over 7 billion people on the planet. All you need is one. So there's no need to settle.
Absolutely not. And the other great thing about being in Swirl with Confidence is maybe you're just not ready to date, but you want to be around a group of like-minded women that will keep you sharp, you know, keep those things going through your head so that when you are ready, all of your tools and everything in place. You know, our motto is be your own matchmaker. Those tools that are out there, you know, the dating sites and so forth that you go to, they are wonderful. No, I would be the first one to say use them if you have access to them. But we are the first ones to say they are tools. They don't manage you. You manage them. So when you are being your own matchmaker, one of the things we're teaching you is how to manage those tools when you are beginning to date or trying to date or whatever it is you want to do. That is one of the things that is best for you. I mean, I liked an analogy that you gave, Michelle. I think it was about a donut shop. I think you can go into a donut shop or something. And how did you do that? I didn't do it quite as well. You gave a great analogy about that. Why don't you tell us?
Right. That particular example, I was talking about the fact that you can look at a donut shop just like you look at the online dating sites. It's a tool. You walk in there, there are going to be chocolate covered donuts. There are going to be glazed donuts. There are going to be donuts with sprinkles. There are going to be cake donuts, a wide variety to choose from. It's just the tool that houses all these different varieties. You have to know what you want Do you want the one with the sprinkles? Do you like a cake as opposed to a glaze? Do you want one that's filled like an eclair? You have to have your mindset right. You have to already have certain things established. And if you don't, you can be on your, you know, you can think about, okay, once you're, because I know that some women, they may say, well, I haven't had standards before, or I haven't really thought about boundaries. No problem. You can start thinking about that and you can start narrowing down. Well, what is it that I like or don't like? What is it that I appreciate or don't appreciate? If I don't like the taste of sprinkles or if I don't like the texture, then I know to not include that in my choice. And that's it's the same thing with dating. You can either you, if you know and have, you know, some surety about what you want and don't want, you can walk in that shop. You can use that tool and say, I want this, this, this. And if not, you can still drill down and figure out what it is you want or don't want.
Or ultimately, you can go to another donut shop if they still do not have what you want. There are so many different things that we discuss. And we, most of all, Michelle, we're going to have fun. I mean, life, there should be good times in life. A lot of our ladies have achieved so much and they have so much going on in their lives. Part of the reason I think they want to expand their dating options is because they want to enjoy it with someone. And I highly applaud that. But until you do, enjoy your life. That's what it's all about.
Exactly. Exactly. And that, I think, too, is another thing that sets us apart, because we look at dating and relationships as one component, one aspect. It's not your totality as a human being. With that holistic approach, mind, body, soul, and spirit, that's a component. That's an aspect of you. You know, you may be, you're being your own matchmaker. You're making your decisions. You're setting these standards and boundaries and you're dating and using these tools, but you're doing other things too. That's not your whole life. There are other things you enjoy. There are other things you're engaging in. There are other things that bring you joy and other things that you're doing maybe in your community or in your family or in your workplace. So we look at the woman from a holistic point of view. Everything is not all focused on dating, dating, dating. That's one aspect of your life. That's not your whole life.
Absolutely. And it takes all of you to date well. You have to have your mind, your spirit, all of these things need to be together and working pretty well together for you to actually have a good mindset in regards to dating and dating well. So, Michelle, now that we've told our ladies, our Swirl Nation, about our group, or at least what we're about in the group and what kind of sets us apart, let's give them some more information in regards to what Swirl with Confidence is all about. Tell them how they can get to us.
All right. All they have to do is go to www.swirlwithconfidence.com and they'll find some more information there, and they'll also find a sign up button where they can join the group. The group is $30 a month, and that's a small price to pay for something that is going to provide so much value. And really, when you think about it, $30 a month is less than a dollar a day.
Absolutely.
And we're well worth that investment for a group that is a supportive, vibrant community of like-minded women who we can hold ourselves accountable to, and also know that this is a safe space where I can be myself and I can laugh and I can engage and I can be challenged and I can be held accountable. And most of all, I can grow as a person and be inspired and motivated. So if they go to swirlwithconfidence.com, they'll find more information and they'll also find where they can sign up and join the group.
Okay, Swirl Nation, see you on the inside.
Thanks for listening. Make sure to like The Swirl World on Facebook and subscribe to the blog at theswirlworld.com.
Head on over to iTunes and subscribe to the podcast or listen directly from our Facebook page.
We can also be heard on SoundCloud and Stitcher Radio.
The Swirl World.
Interracial.
Diverse.
Beautiful.